Hello everyone and welcome to our channel AglaSem Schools. So guys, today we are going to discuss the solutions for chapter number 15, which is Light from NCERT class 7th science book. In this chapter, we have covered topics including formation, nature and different phenomenon of light. It also talks about image formation and various types of lenses. Along with it, it also includes various examples and activities that help makes our studies fun. We believe you all must be well versed with the chapter by now. So let's quickly proceed towards the NCERT questions and their solutions. Question number 1 starts with an exercise which includes fill in the blank type statements. Here, we will fill in the blanks with the correct answers for all those statements. Question number 1, part A. An image that cannot be obtained on a screen is called virtual image. Part B. Image formed by a convex dash is always virtual and smaller in size. Answer is mirror. Part number C. An image formed by a dash mirror is always of the same size as that of the object. Answer is plane. Part number D. An image which can be obtained on a screen is called dash image. Answer is real. Part number E. An image formed by a concave dash cannot be obtained on a screen. Answer is lens. Moving on to the next question. Question number 2. Mark T if the statement is true and F if the statement is false. So it's nothing but a true-false based question. Part number A. We can obtain an enlarged and erect image by a convex mirror. This statement is false. Part B. A concave lens always forms a virtual image. This statement is true. Part number C. We can obtain a real, enlarged and inverted image by a concave mirror. This statement is true. Part number D. A real image cannot be obtained on a screen. This statement is false. Part number E. A concave mirror always forms a real image. This statement is again false. Moving on to the next question, we have to find and match the most suitable answers for the following. Question number 3 says, match the items given in column 1 with one or more items of column number 2nd. So we'll start with part A. A plane mirror matches with the image is erect and of the same size as the object. Part B. A convex mirror matches with can form image of objects spread over a large area. Part C. A convex lens matches with used as a magnifying glass. Part D. A concave mirror. This matches with the image is always inverted and magnified. Part number E. A concave lens. This matches with the image is erect and of the same size as the object. Question number 4. State the characteristics of the image formed by a plane mirror. Answer to this question would be, an image formed by a plane mirror has the following characteristics. Number 1. The image formed by a plane mirror is erect. Number 2. It is virtual and is of the same size as the object. Number 3. The image is at the same distance behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. Now coming to question number 5. It says, find out a letter of English alphabet or any other language known to you in which the image formed in a plane mirror appears exactly like itself. Discuss your findings. This we feel can be carried out by all of us. You may share your findings with your friends and classmates. Moving on to question number 6. What is virtual image? Give one situation where a virtual image is formed. Answer. Virtual image is something that cannot be obtained on a screen. The image which is formed by a plane mirror and could not be obtained on a screen when placed either in front or behind the mirror. Such an image that is formed is called virtual image. Moving on to next question, that is question number 7. State two differences between a convex and a concave lens. Answer. Convex lens or a lens that is thicker in the middle focuses the light to a specific point, whereas concave lens, that is thinner in the middle of the diverging lens, diverges the light rays. Second, A convex lens makes both real and virtual image, but a concave lens always forms only virtual image. Coming to question number 8, give one use of each of a concave and a convex mirror. Answer: convex mirrors are usually used as rear and side view mirrors. For example, mirrors used in cars are convex mirrors. Second, concave mirrors can be used in reflecting telescope to provide magnifying image. It can also be used in torch or headlight of vehicles. Now moving forward to question number 9, which type of mirror can form a real image? We already know the answer, and it is a concave mirror can form a real image. Question number 10, which type of lens forms always a virtual image? Here, the answer is concave lens, because concave lens forms a virtual image. Now, coming to question number 11, a virtual image larger than the object can be produced by a... Answer is part number 2, concave mirror, because it can form virtual and magnified image of an object. Concave lens and convex mirror forms virtual but diminished image of an object. And lastly, the plane mirror, it forms virtual and same size image of the object. Next question, that is question number 12, which says David is observing his image in a plane mirror. The distance between the mirror and his image is 4 meter. If he moves 1 meter towards the mirror, then the distance between David and his image will be... Answer is part number 3, 6 meter. This is because in case of a plane mirror, the distance between an object and mirror is same as distance between the image and the mirror. So, if David moves towards the mirror by 1 meter, the distance between David and his image, that was 8 meters, gets reduced by 1 plus 1, 2 meters, bringing it down to 6 meters. Now, coming to last question, question number 13. The rear view mirror of a car is a plane mirror. A driver is reversing his car at a speed of 2 meter per second. The driver sees in his rear view mirror the image of a truck parked behind his car. The speed at which the image of the truck appears to approach the driver will be... Answer is 4 meter per second. The reason being, speed at which car is approaching the truck is 2 meters per second. The distance at which car and truck will decrease at a double rate. Do you know why? Yes, simply because the image of truck will travel a distance twice the distance traveled by the car in equal time. Hence, the image of truck will appear to approach the driver with a speed of 2 multiplied 2, that is 4 meters per second. So guys, this was all for chapter number 15. Hope you liked the video, and if you did, then don't forget to like and share this video with your friends. If you still have any doubts regarding this chapter, then feel free to ask us in our comment section below. And yes, do not forget to subscribe to our channel for more NCERT videos of other subjects too. See you soon. Bye-bye.